thing real quick. My residency is going to be going on for the rest of this month. This is the poster for it. I have some copies of this poster for very, very low price. Roger has some other amazing posters for an even lower price. So he can tell you about those, but thank you for doing that. This is Katie Kincaid that did this, and I love this, and it's been super fun. So another little series that I do that I would love to invite you all to come to is in the East Bay. Every first Thursday of the month, I do this series called Songs About Something, and it's similar to this, except it has a theme. And one time somewhere I heard an artist, a songwriter, I didn't remember who it was, said that every artist set should have something old, something new, something borrowed, and something blue, to borrow from the bridal tradition. And so this is a series that I'm doing with songwriters similar to this, but we all play an old song, we all play a new song, we all play a borrowed song, a cover song, which we can do there, and then we all play a blues song or a blues song or a sad song or something about the word blue or anything like that. This can be your interpretation. So it's a really kind of fun, themed way to do this, and then we all play mini sets. And so in December, on December 1st, it's going to be James Nash from the Waybacks. Tom Broon, who is a touring songwriter based in Southern California. He's played with Ben Harper and all kinds of folks, won some awards. He's a very prolific, awesome songwriter. And then also Tim McCaffrey from the Little Feller Band. And then in January, I'm also going to be back at Ivy Room first Thursday. The Songs About Something is going to be the AL Bro version, I'm calling it. So I've got Lebo and Steve Adams from ALO, and Alex and Ben Morrison from the Brothers Comatose. So it's going to be the two brothers and then the other two boys, so I'm going to be all in the middle of the boys again, which is super fun for me. So, and that goes on from there. So you can get information about that on my website, which is pageclem.com. I'm also, I'll tell you real quickly, in the middle of crowdfunding for my first album. It's a full-length album, and a lot of these songs you've heard tonight are on that, so you can find out details about that there as well. And when we're going around in this round, I hope these guys will let you know when they're playing around too, and if they have any merch or things like that. So there you go. We're going to start up now with another song. This is a song, I still haven't fully come up with a working title for it, but I think we're calling it the La La song for now. And this has a part for you as well, which Jordan will help you with, but it goes like la 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 la. So. This is a song like for basically like blissful ignorance, or like when you meet somebody and all the signs are there that you shouldn't do it and you want to do it anyway. Kind of the epitome of that. You feel like danger, heartache, all kinds of pain, fear I can't get your crazy train. I can't see, but I know what's round the bend. It don't matter now, I'm stuck here again. And I know you could break my heart in two. part is her walking off into the distance, like in ignorant bliss. Ignoring the red flags, ignoring the burning building, ignoring the roaring train.
Lola, you can never hurt me. I'll be fine.
You never know, maybe it works out.
Every rock star I liked was going to die in the space of about 2 weeks. And before Bowie, before Prince, I thought it was already a disaster. So I wrote a song about it. It's called Winter of Love.
Darkness stops the dawn. Another day, another hero gone. Rock and roll may never die, not so those who gave it life. One by one,
I'm
So while Pat's moving around, I'll tell you that Pat and I are also doing a show together soon at Ivy Room on January 6th, which is a Friday night. Shaky Zimmerman, this band that Pat's assembled with Jody Salino. Yeah, really super fun band, and I've had the treat of getting to sing some songs with them too. So check that out. Shaky Zimmerman.
Serious hard word coming out.
Shake,
you can hurt somebody with one of those things.
I hate these things. Boy, the whole Bob Dylan, Neil Young thing. You just, like, can't get out of town. With the, it's like you gotta have it. It's like walking around with a car bumper on your neck. Tish, tish. Bumping into microphones all the time in the middle of songs. Sound guys hate me.
That's basically the same technology that's been around for the last 4 years. Yes.
I don't know where the harmonica came from. Where did it come from? Germany?
Hold on.
Yeah. That was just a freaking lucky guess by me. I'm from Kentucky. So I'm playing Shaky Zimmerman. It's kind of I have some CDs here. I mean, 2 minutes, less than 2 minutes for sure story. Man, when I first started playing out here, I didn't play music for a long time, and I just moved out here in 94, like in September of 94, because I was afraid that, I just wanted to keep seeing Jerry Garcia play. And it was 9 months later, he was gone. I was in shock. I stopped playing music. Then I started playing again in a little bit. I got back into Neil Young and Bob Dylan that I like a lot. And Graham Parsons I really like. Some other stuff. I did some Dead stuff because I'm just a deadhead like all of us are. And my CD came out and I got these guys that I met by going to see the David Nelson band play. I got these guys. First I asked Bill Lehman on the corner outside the Oakland Metro. And then I asked Barry Sless. And they both said, sure, we'll be on your CD. And Neil Young, Bob Dylan's awesome. That's how I came to know Roger way back when. Because the Flying Other Brothers and the David Nelson Band let me on the bill one night at the Little Fox Theater way back when Tom Miller first started doing the show. It got me back into music, you know? And I was like, who's that Roger guy? You know, and I was like, you know, this Nelson.
I'm still asking.
Yeah, I went to.
Who is that Roger?
No, I was like, yeah, I was so happy. And then I went away for a long time again. Then I came back. Grateful Dead cover bands or whatever. Now a Neil Young band. But here's another one of my originals. It's kind of in the Neil Young world a little bit, I would say. I haven't played this one again in probably 8 years, but it was definitely written at a time when I didn't know what was going on. I do now, but see if I can get through it. I don't know. This is the original cheat sheet for it I have for it.
These lost
pretty.
Thank you, Paige.
How long we got? So I know which side we're doing. Nobody's leaving, right?
So this would be one. Do we have time for two more rounds?
I don't know how long that takes.
All
right. Let's do
going.
Two more rounds.
All right.
Two more rounds.
Goodness.
Does that make you happy?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, we'll make them happy.
Okay.
Yes.
Everybody will come back to Bazaar Cafe and support Les because we got an extra row.
Right.
Yeah.
Does that make you happy?
Let's hear it.
Yeah, actually, let's thank
let's
Les.
Let's hear it for
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Les is like a father to a lot of songwriters around here, and we love him and appreciate him.
So Paige has a La La song, and we played together a couple weeks ago. I'm like, oh my god, I have a La La song. So this is my La La song. It's called One of These Days. This was written in 85, and I think it's only been played three times, something like that.
Wow.
The La La's are super easy. You guys will get them. That's it.
One of these days, and I hate just saying that. One of these days, I'm gonna find.
Sit outside as a thief, Lala. All right.
Those two just went, ooh.
There's a lot going on.
La, 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 la.
I'm Lala la free.
And Lala. La, la, la.
All right, so are we going to try this one? Narcissist?
Don't
look at me. Don't look at me.
Alright, okay.
I've never been a thief.
So this next song has a lot of words. I'm going to make sure I've got them just in case I need them. And what I want you to know about this song is that I did not write it about the person that you think I wrote it about. However, it doesn't matter. Because they're all the same. So think about that if you hear these words, because it's pretty powerful in that it's that, like, you know, Mayo Clinic definition, for lack of a better way of putting it. So anyway, you'll get the point in just a second. All right.
Narcissist, just save your breath. Your words are
Politicians say it's time to pray. Every time the same old story, images both sad and gory. Bullets rule another day while politicians say it's time to pray. Take your thoughts and prayers, scatter them across the thoughts and prayers are all you have. Stay away from me. Stay away from me. Politicians say it's time to pray. We're only safe when packing heat in schools and churches, on the street, the handiwork of the NRA. But politicians say it's time to pray. Take your thoughts and prayers, scatter them across the thoughts and prayers are all you have. Stay away from me. Stay away from me. Orlando, Newtown, San Bernardino, Charleston, Blacksburg, Tucson, DeKalb, Roseburg, Oakland, Santa Monica, Aurora, Columbine, and every town went on. But time has come. The time has come. The time has come to stand and fight. Not getting shot is a human right. Join us and take a stand.
tapped out of water here? Oh, the whole thing? Cup. So, do any of you guys have any gigs coming up? Can you tell us about? Jordan? You got any shows coming up?
Pretty much always.
That's good. That's true. Jordan plays like, I don't know, like 10 shows a week. He plays like multiple, like 2 or 3 a night.
Depending on the month, I play in between 15 and 30 bands. Oh my god. I keep listening for hire. You know, there's like 20 of us. yeah, so let's see. Where am I this week?
Where are you? Where can people follow Jordan on Twitter? Jordan the Ritual.
No, website jordantheritual.com, which is dying for an upgrade or a redo.
You're probably all. Who's Facebook friends with Jordan in here?
Oh,
raise your hand. Look,
sure,
see?
Yeah.
Wait, my father's putting up his hand. You don't even have a Facebook account. He just looks at my mom's or whatsoever. He doesn't even know what, like. He doesn't waste his time, though. It's great. I'm very impressed.
I'm sitting in this chair.
The hot seat.
Yeah. So, back in the Deadbeats days, we recorded a couple albums. That Something Someday song was supposed to be on our third album, but we broke up. One time, and this was going to be on it too, we all like picked, we used to do them live, we picked like some traditional songs, wrote our own music to it, and I wrote this one and I didn't want to play it, and my friend Robin Gaskin from Cleveland, Ohio, she said I like that song, so I kept doing it. Deadbeats used to do it. It's a nursery rhyme. I think it's like from back in the Abraham Lincoln days. But everybody kind of like. And then I wanted to like write something sort of in the Ico, Ico, Hey Pocky Way world, you know, it was still like in the heyday of the Grateful Dead, so I wanted to get something in that world too, and would Bob approve of it kind of thing.
Thank you. to my room. Skip to my room. Skip to my room.
Ooh.
Felted tip jar again. So this is to compensate the musicians that are performing tonight. I have a babysitter at home, just saying. Thanks, everybody. We'll say a little farewell when we're out of here. This next song, are you on it, you think? This dude, don't know you. Yeah. So I went home to Alabama. I'm from Alabama originally. That's why I went home there. I went home last summer, and my first guitar that I ever got, my dad gave it to me, and it's this beautiful old Dreadnought Martin. I brought it back recently, but that's not it.
Stop.
Oh, is it app? You got an app going? That's great. All right. So Jordan's queuing up my sound effects. Anyway, I wrote this song last year in August, sitting outside. It was the first night I got there, and it was just, you know, it's just such a great thing to go back home. And this is kind of funny. I usually use my phone for this song, and my phone is recording live on Facebook. Hey guys, thanks, Keenan. I hope you got it. Hey, it's my boss. In Essence, and Kid was here last week. Alright, so this song is a song that I wrote. That's pretty good. Turn it down just a hair. Yeah. You guys get the vibe. Anyway, I'm just going to play this song. It needs to be louder than that. Can you guys hear the crickets in the back? Okay.
I can hear that.
Yes, sorry, everything's falling apart. It's been the best night ever, and then it all just collapses at the end there. Anyway, this was a song I wrote when I was sitting outside. There were literally fireflies buzzing around, and I was thinking about my dad, who's been recently diagnosed with dementia. And so this song's kind of about Alabama, and it's kind of about fireflies, and it's kind of about my dad, and it's really about the impermanence of all things.
I'm not afraid to die.
I can ever remember, but something good did actually happen. I went to see a wise old woman to ask her what to do. She said, there's only one thing works for me, but it might just work for you. Take a couple of puffs. Yes, couple of puffs. That's just enough. Yes, couple of puffs. No matter what, no matter when, on cannabis you can depend. Make each moment happy as can be. Take a couple of puffs. Couple of puffs when I wake up starts my day out right. A couple more with breakfast helps my appetite. A couple of puffs before I face the world makes the sunshine bright. I'm so glad to be alive, let you share my life. Take a couple of puffs. Yes, couple of puffs. Yes, couple of puffs. No matter what, no matter when, on cannabis you can depend. Make each moment happy as can be. Take a couple of puffs. A couple of puffs with the one I love, like fine champagne from France. A couple of puffs with my doctor and the guy who feeds the plants. A couple of puffs with the policeman. He's cool, he'll take a chance. He's so glad to be alive, to puffs then pass then dance. Take a couple of puffs.
Couple of puffs.
Yes, couple of puffs.
Yes, couple of puffs.
And just, you know.
Couple of puffs.
Yes, a couple of puffs.
Couple of puffs.
No matter what, no matter when. I got to apologize to Gail Barnes because I intended to play her song tonight, but we didn't quite have enough time. I am going to be playing with the Doobie Decibel Trio on Friday and Saturday nights at Sweetwater if
nice.
You guys are free. We're playing with Tom Hamilton's American Babies, and
nice.
So
right.
we'll be opening those shows, and I think those are the last ones this year, so please do come out. Thank you so very, very much.
And thank you. I would like to thank you all for coming out tonight. It's like a really special night. Like, I don't get to play a lot of my own songs, so I feel really good tonight. I feel really good to be here with Jordan, who I've been palling around with for a few years, Roger, and I want to thank Paige for inviting me.
Right.
Thanks to Bazaar Cafe for hosting us this whole month. It's just been a great time. Want to let y'all know, peace and love. So, that was a great song, Roger, by the way. I mean, really, this guy's a great songwriter. But really, like, you know how to hit the nail with that one, man. Like, I love the smoke pot. That's my wife. She's got a big problem.
They have no idea what that song's about, you know?
No.
A little bit of dragon.
I just incriminated myself big time. Like Carrie told me, don't say anything about anything. So let's see here. Here's one from the old Dead Beats days.
Mom goes off. It's 5 o'clock. Gotta get moving or I might get down. 5 men wouldn't let me sleeping free. The morning sun starts to rise, peels the sleep from my eyes. It's begun. I'm still.
Thank you.
guys still with me yet?
It's been
a while. Go ahead.
One more song back in the vocals. So much work.
Yeah. I mean, how we feel.
Alright, so this one is called Oh My Everything. And if there's more time I can do about this video idea, but I'm just gonna put a song in the next time. Okay, chorus. Once again, super easy. Paige is gonna help me out. Parents are here, but they call themselves the Feinsteins, so it's weird. All the kids, yeah, you can clap for them, it's alright. And I would say, like, you know, they came out all this way. No, they live in Berkeley, they drove across the bridge. Here we go, you guys with me on this?
We're ready.
Yeah. E minor, C, G, A minor. Most of the spell, yeah, that's the chorus. Hold on, let's sit down. I always Sam when I play keyboards also, so this was very strange. Hi. Is that how you guys do this?
No, that's not. You can't strike rock. Rock star poses when you're sitting down.
What is going on here? Someone's getting fired over this. I think it's me. All these guitar issues.
Les is going to start rolling his eyes at me.
You're there.
We got you.
You're there. We got you.
Just wasted day. Yeah.
I've got some for the residency if you'd like. Huge thanks to Pat Nevins. Go see Shaky Zimmerman. Follow Pat.
ShakyZimmerman.com.
There you go. Jordan Feinstein Stein. You can find me at PaigeClem.com. Paige with an I. I'm going to let you talk in just a second. Roger McNamee. Go see Roger.
We've been at this for a few years, as you might know. There have been many memorable shows here. Kerouac taught us that comparisons are odious. So I won't compare. But we have our own little pantheon. This is in our pantheon.